Hey guys, welcome to a new episode of The Rachel Cruze Show. And I'm here to remind you that we have a new format. So we'll be releasing each segment every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. Hope you like it. Take a listen. Well, hey, you guys. So I spend a lot of time talking about not buying things you don't need. Instagram loves to make us feel like we're just one purchase away of just being complete forever, right? And it's this like comparison culture of like what I don't have and what I'm missing out on, all the things. And I will also admit that there are some purchases, though, that I have made in life that are very much worth it. So today, I want to share the 7 purchases that have significantly improved my life. And spoiler alert, number 7 was 10 years in the making. So, you know, I'm not playing around. It's so good. And be sure to stick around and let me know in the comments 2 different things. Number 1, what's one purchase that you think is worth it? And number 2, if you like this subject, should I do another episode of just this kind of thing? All right, first off, let's kick things off with a little warm weather staple in our house. And I know this sounds really random and simple, but if you're needing a cheap way to get your kids outside and just keep them occupied, I am telling you, a pack of wiffle balls does the trick. So my kids, I don't know about yours, but it's like things get lost all the time. And so buying anything expensive for outside just stresses me out. But when I go to like Big Lots or the Dollar Tree or even just some cheap Amazon stuff, they play with it. And it may only last a season, but it keeps them occupied. And I'm telling you, give my kids a stick and a ball or a bat and a ball, like whatever it is, they will play outside forever, like forever. And I have learned if I can just invest in a big thing of wiffle balls, they're good to go. Like it really is amazing. So all day, every day, I'm doing it this summer. I'll do it next summer. It's great. All right, next is a book purchase that changed my life. So I love to read and I'll read 3 or 4 books a month. Usually I'll read fiction that has to do with like murder and kidnapping or something really dark and crazy, but they're always thrillers and crazy and great. But every now and again, I will read a nonfiction and try to grow as a person, which I think is very important. But one of my favorite books of all time, one that I've read probably 3 different times over the course of a decade, is The Voice of the Heart by Chip Dodd. Okay, if you've not read this book, it is kind of like your first step into therapy. If you've never really dug into that space of life, it is so good. He just talks about the basic emotions and how there's like a healthy side of every emotion. Yeah, a healthy side of even like an anger, like all this. Like it's so interesting. Or the unhealthy side, the low points of it. And so he just talks through each of those. And it is incredible. It's so great to pinpoint because kind of like, I feel like therapy 101 is like your emotions are your dashboard, right? They're just indicating things going on underneath the hood. And this is the first step into that language. And it's just, again, very helpful, very self-aware to understand these things. And it sounds really simple, but it's really good. So Voice of the Heart, Chip Dodd. I actually had him on the show a few years ago. It was a great interview. All right, speaking of self-help and self-care, the third purchase that dramatically improved my life is therapy. A good old therapy session. Now listen, there are seasons in my life that I will go every week for like a year. Like some things just come up and I'm like, wow, we will work on this for a while. And then sometimes I won't go for like 6 months. So for me, it is very seasonal in what's going on in my life. But can I tell you, I always walk away from a session just being like, okay, that was so good to know. Again, the self-awareness, the mirroring back, and understanding who we are as people. I am no Dr. John Deloney here, but it is amazing the layers that you have in yourself and in your story all the way back to childhood, all the way about how you are today. And when you can understand, oh my gosh, I go out sideways when this happens or that, or why am I doing this? It just helps you overall become aware. And I think you just become, I was going to say a better human, but seriously, I think you become a better friend, a better sister, a better daughter, a better wife or mom, or if you're the dude version, you know, all the other dude versions of that. Like you just overall become a healthier person. And I think that is so worth the investment. All right. The fourth purchase that has significantly improved my life, and I would say millions of other people, is FPU, Financial Peace University. Yep. I had to take this as a wee little girl, as you can imagine. So FPU is a 9-lesson personal finance course that goes over all the basics with money that you need to know. Again, some really simple ideas, but things that are hard to do, like budgeting or getting out of debt, to even more complex topics like insurance and investing, all of that you will learn. And it's the stuff about money that everyone wishes they knew in high school, starting out at 18 years old. So if you have not taken FPU, make sure to check it out. I will leave a link in the description. Again, it is worth the money. All right, the fifth purchase that has significantly improved my life is a kitchen gadget that I swear by. This is like one thing I use, I would say at least probably 3 to 4 times a week. And it's the Pampered Chef Veggie Chopper. And I'm sure there's a lot of these. But it's just, I mean, it's incredible. Like, it comes with 2 different sizes of what's chopped, and you need something chopped, you just throw it in and I mean, it's from onions to peppers. I mean, anything that needs to be chopped, that dang chopper will do it. Saves you time. It saves you money because all the pre-chopped stuff, you guys, the grocery store is more expensive. So don't buy that. Just buy it in whole. Get a great chopper that you can use over and over again. But it's a kitchen tool that, again, I love so much. Throw in the dishwasher. It's clean. It's wonderful. You need it. All right, the sixth purchase that I swear by that I really strongly believe everyone needs is term life insurance. Now, a lot of people mistakenly choose whole life insurance because they think, I don't know, sometimes there's an investment involved and they sell you on that plan. Or you think, okay, maybe, you know, I need it for my whole life. Or maybe you think I don't even need insurance at all. Here's the deal. If someone is dependent upon your income, you need life insurance, and specifically term life. Term life is what I recommend. It is way less expensive than whole life. It doesn't have an investment involved or a savings, you know, portion of it. This is strictly just insurance. That's all you need. Don't ever combine insurances and investments together. It's always going to be a bad deal. So make sure those are separate. You're investing separately and you have term life insurance. So you need, and you know, about 10 to 12 times your annual income. And if you're a stay-at-home parent, I would say anywhere from $500,000 to even $600,000. So if someone is dependent upon you, the work that you do or your income that you're bringing in, you need term life. Xander Insurance is who I recommend you check out because they actually go and shop a ton of different insurance companies and get you the best rate. It's what Winston and I use. And it's fantastic. So making sure term life insurance is part of one of the purchases you make in life, it is worth it. All right, the seventh purchase that has significantly improved my life, it is the most bougie, but it's one that, I mean, it's just been great. And that is a big designer tote. So listen, my Never Full Tote by Louis Vuitton has gone strong for 10 years, you guys. I mean, everywhere, work, airplanes, anniversary dinners, kids' sports practices. I mean, you name it. This was the purse that I went to all the time. And I have found I don't switch purses a lot. Like, I just have too much crap, too much going on to like take all these little things. Every now and then I'll do a smaller purse, but for the most part, I just have one big tote that I take with me everywhere. And if you get a nice one, this is what I've learned, because Target and all of that, they have, you know, some great purses, but sometimes they do break over like 5 or 6 years. But again, your designer ones, that is real leather. Again, they're going to cost you, but they're actually really great quality. They will hold up. Like, I just can't believe my Neverfull. I mean, it's been 10 years. And my last birthday, I changed purses. I changed totes. Louie is still there. She's still around. But I've moved on to another tote because I was like, it's been a decade. I'm going to do one more for the next decade of my life. But it is worth it. It is worth it for me. I love it. Again, it's bougie and we love Old Navy. We love Target. Like, we love Amazon, all of that. But having one nice tote that will last forever and ever, amen, is worth it for me. All right, you guys. It's time to hear from you all. So again, drop a comment because I want to know a purchase that has improved your life, because I love hearing what you guys are buying, because usually it ends up being something that I love too. So let's help each other out. And I want to give you a heads up also on things that I have regretted buying on my episode, Popular Products That Are a Waste of Money. And that's coming up next. All right, you guys, remember to take control of your money and create a life you love.